Esther first saw the Armenian man, who groveled toward her and stood by her side with a bucket that swung in his hand. His grin stretched the folds of his pasty white cheeks, and his lips hurled a dollop of murk on the curb. And the lights from the rides showed a mischievous sparkle that flashed in his hollow-eyed stare. He said, "Little girl, you can chop off my legs and then peel off my socks if you want to. But I'd rather you took this old puppet from me that I hold in my tail as we speak." And he stood looking down at the innocent girl, and she stared at the bucket, bewildered. Then he lifted the doll for the young girl to see, and a giant smile grew on his face. She saw the doll's eyes, and she couldn't resist, and she thanked the man quickly and ran to the church. And she burst through the doorway with puppet held high, and a hush filled the chapel, and the people looked round. Tried in vain to pacify the mob, quibbled the puppet on her rug. Feeling quite outnumbered, Esther hid behind a nearby pile of lumber, where she waited till the dawn. Cause it would have been a blunder to succumb to a hula mama prowl.